course, is the Sycamore fight song. We have some people bobbing their heads in the studio, so it must be we got some Spartans in the studio. I do believe we do. We also have the principal of the Sycamore Middle School, James Cleven, if I'm saying that right. James, right?
Cleven.
How you doing, man? I'll just call you James. How you doing, James?
Very good.
Great to see you. Thanks for accommodating us. I know we were supposed to be in here earlier, but we had to rearrange things. But we're still before the Science Olympiad, right? When is that
coming
up?
We are. That is coming up March.
March 8th.
March 8th. Yeah. So we're going to learn about that. Matter of fact, let's go right to, we have Justin Hams with us. Justin is the Science Department Chair. Justin, how you doing, my friend?
I'm doing well. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for that. Now, the Science Olympiad, when we hear this, it's like the science fair we had like when I was a kid in school?
No, a little different. As a matter of fact, it started as a result of we wanted an alternative to that.
Okay.
It happened 32 years ago. Department Chair at the time named Rich Knutson, he approached the principal at the time and said, can we do something competition-based? So it's basically these problem-based competitions where kids compete, you know, they're building structures, boats, towers, whatever it may be, where there's some challenge they have to compete for a gold, silver, or bronze medal. So it's pretty fun.
Okay. Now, I know, James, you weren't involved with that decision to do that. But
I was not.
But making it a competition, it's a friendly kind of competition, but it kind of stimulates growth, doesn't it?
It does, and we have some experts here that will tell you all about what's going on in the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade.
All right, let's meet some of those experts right now. Well, it's always a ladies first, so let's meet. We have a Natalie. Is that right? Tell us your full name, Natalie.
Yeah, my name is Natalie Heth, and I've done a lot with our science department.
All right, well, tell us about Natalie. Why have you always been interested in science?
Yeah, as long as I can remember, I've always been really interested in STEM.
Can you remember, was there one thing, like, did you go see something, or like you watched a ball hit another ball and said, you know, that's fascinating? What made you?
I've always really been into the medical field and just seeing how much science is into that. I've always been very interested.
Okay, now when you say you're into the medical field, what does that mean? Do you watch medical shows on television, or is it more than
yes,
that?
Yes, and my dad is in the medical field.
Okay.
And I've always wanted to become an anesthesiologist.
Really?
So, yeah.
Now, why an anesthesiologist?
I've always, like, what they do, they're really helpful. Like, how could we do surgeries without them?
Right.
And
they're kind of underrated, aren't they?
Yeah, and they make decent money too.
Well, yeah. So. That doesn't hurt at all. So when you told your dad that, how did he react to that? What he said, you might
he
want to
he was very pleased. He's always wanted me to go into the medical field.
Okay, so now did your science? Can I call it a science project? What do I call it?
Science Olympiad.
Okay, so tell us about your project. What did you do?
Well, I haven't done that, but I'm getting ready to do the big science thing for 8th grade where we do a big project that we choose, and I'm going to do elephant toothpaste, which is basically a big foam explosion.
Now, wait, elephant toothpaste, is that an actual thing, or what is it?
That's what they call it.
It's, and you keep it in your trunk, right? That's an elephant joke, all right? No, but what exactly is elephant toothpaste?
It's a mix of a couple chemicals, and it basically creates a gigantic foam explosion.
Okay. So can you only do it once, or how will you do that
You just add, you have your base chemicals, and then once you add, I want to say it's some type of peroxide, you get a gigantic foam, and you can add colors to it. It's just a big explosion.
Well, now, Justin, help me out. When I was an 8th grade, a kid did a volcano. He had an active volcano. I'm guessing you used a lot of the same elements there, huh?
Yeah, you could do it with that. If you YouTube, elephant toothpaste, you'll find all kinds of things where people are doing this, but I think it's potassium iodide and hydrogen peroxide is what you mentioned to me, Natalie, you're going to do. And it's just kind of one of those. It's called an exothermic reaction. So it gets very hot, expands, and it goes shooting out of the test tube that you're doing it. And it's kind of just one of those. It's just very, very fun to see.
Now, Natalie, why the name? Where does the elephant toothpaste come from?
I have no idea, but that's the name of it was on Jimmy Fallon.
Okay.
That's how I got the idea.
Oh, is that where you got the idea from? Okay. All right, we want to talk to you some more, but let's meet the guy with the cool name, Jaxon with an X. Is that right, Jaxon? Tell us about that name. That's cool.
My name's Jaxon Lang. I've been into science just like my friend Natalie here for a very long time. Not the medical field, but the engineering field.
All right.
To figure out different ways on how to make cars more clean, like they have been doing for these past few years, and possibly learn how to use the mag the magnetic powers to put them in roads and make cars like float like a maglev train.
All right, I want to talk about that. First, tell me about your name, though. Why the X in Jaxon? What is that about?
My parents wanted a unique name. They just didn't want it to be the old Jackson. So, like, you know what? Let's just slap an X in there. And
I like it.
You got a unique name.
Are you Jax? Is that what you go by now, or what?
Sometimes yes.
Or the X-Man? Also, we could call you.
No, not the X-Man. I wish, but not all the time, though.
So now, why engineering? What was it that was your Hot Wheels you got into it? And you're like, you know what? I'm going to want to do this when I get older, too.
No, not the Hot Wheels. I've always been fascinated by the combustion engines and the cars and how they all work and how you can improve it to make a car run smoother and not make the loud revving sound that you get.
Okay. So what are you doing? And what specifically are you doing in terms of do you have a project for this and pertaining to that?
No, not really. But I've also been fascinated with, like, the plane wings. So I thought about doing, the project that, like, Natalie was talking about, where you could take the plane wings and you could see how it affects how far a plane flies.
Oh, the plane wings. Okay, all right.
So, like, if you put the planes in a certain position, like, always facing up, will it fly further than if they're just facing down all the time?
Really?
Yeah.
So tell us about your fascination with cars, because I find that very interesting, because I have trouble putting oil in my car. I have somebody, I pay somebody to do that. But do you liked it from a young age, and have you worked on engines?
Yes, I've loved it from a young age. I've seen an engine. I haven't worked on an engine before. But yes, I have loved them from a very young age, and it's always been a fascination of mine to figure out how to make a car run smoother and quieter.
Now, does your dad and brother, do they work on cars? Do you work with them? Or your sister, I should say?
I have a younger sister. She knows somewhat about cars, and my dad actually teaches science at the middle school at the 7th grade level, so yes, he knows a lot about cars as well.
Okay, because I always love the question, nature versus nurture. Do you think if your dad wasn't into that, would you be into it, or vice versa? Do you think that's reason why?
I think my dad wasn't into it. Yes, I would still be into it, because it would still be my fascination, because even though he wouldn't be in the science field or the engineering field, I would still love it because he would love my choice no matter what I did.
Well, good answer. You should be a politician, too. And Natalie, how about you? Same question now. Do you think if your dad wasn't involved with the medical field, you wouldn't get involved? Or what do you think?
Probably not. I've always been very interested in medical. I've always wanted to help people. That's always been my big thing.
That's a wonderful thing. Now, James, when we hear this, obviously, you know, we hear about more and more kids not necessarily going to college, going like the way Jaxon might go in terms of a different type of school. What do you think about that? And getting these kids more interested at his age?
That's why we offer so many hands-on types of skills at our school. We do have programs where we do the industrial tech and in the careers side of it. So mm-hmm. there's so much to do that we just, you know, we have to offer more than just the books, because the kids love the hands-on.
Yeah, I think it's great, mm-hmm. too. Now, Justin, tell us about the categories. You said you let the kids pretty much pick whatever they want. How do you do that, and how do they compete against each other?
Yeah, so the competitions have remained relatively the same over the 32 period, but the philosophy is just to get kids engaged in, like, a problem-solving activity, but also working as a team. You know, where they have a certain time limit to mm-hmm. design something that serves a specific function, and then they put it to the test, and we have some measurable variable about that where we determine who the winner is.
Okay.
And like in a pressure-filled situation, they have to figure it out. So the competitions range from, in eighth grade, we do an egg drop competition where they have to design a structure that protects an egg when you drop it from the top of a ladder that's about 10 feet tall.
Okay.
And you know, in seventh grade, they're building boats that have to contain and float, and you drop little weights in them, and the one that holds the most weights that ends up winning the competition. In sixth grade, if you go into the main gym, you'll see kids launching marshmallows all the way across the gym, and they have to figure out what trajectory and all that to launch the marshmallow at, and whoever can launch it the farthest onto a target wins. But the thing I like the best of it is as you walk from building or from room to room on Science Olympiad night, you just see kids having fun.
Uh-huh.
You know, they're always a little skeptical when you tell them in the classroom because, you know, it's an academic activity and, like, oh, I don't know if I want to sign up for that. But the kids who come really always come away from it saying, wow, I had a great time. You know, they hang out with their friends, but they're also very engaged. You can tell by the conversations they're having how much they enjoy it, and that's why we keep doing it year after year.
And Natalie, what do your classmates say to you when you tell them what you're doing and you're explaining it to them?
They all seem very excited. I have a lot of friends who have already made teams for Tuesday coming up, and they're super excited.
That's great. And you kind of the leader? Do you kind of just find yourself naturally becoming the leader in the group?
I've always kind of been a leader figure with
I kind of guessed that about you. That's a good thing. It's a great attribute to have. All right. Well, how about you, Jaxon? Same deal? Do you like to work with – and I know you love the automotive stuff, Jaxon. So do you mind doing this other stuff? Do you consider that a waste of time? You want to just focus on the engines, or is that interesting to you as well?
The other stuff that we do with the Science Olympiad, yes, it's very interesting because the same way happens. You have to figure out how to construct or engineer a structure or a ramp to safely hold something or make it go as slow as possible to, without falling off or stopping on the table. So, and I've always been a leader with all of the groups I've been in. Everybody looks up to me.
That's
and
great.
Says, I want to be you when I get older. And even my grandparents, they joke around, when I get older, I want to be like you, Jaxon.
All right. So. That's a great thing to know, boy. All right, Jaxon, I want to know, because I'm always confused with the hybrids. A friend of mine has a hybrid, and he says the electric engine takes over when the gas engine stops, and I'm confused about that. Can you explain that to me? What is happening there?
So with the hybrids, the electric engine, yes, it does take over when either the car runs out of gas or the gas engine or the combustion engine, as we like to call it, stops working. The electric engine does take over. That way your car can keep going even if it's on a low tank. And then the electricity just runs out. It takes away from the car battery. And then there's, with the Tesla, I know they've built like electric car charging stations where you can go charge your car.
Okay. All right, that's great, man. All right, Natalie, you're putting me under, and I start to have a reaction. Now, what are you going to do? I'm starting to react to the gas that you're putting me under. What does Natalie do?
I don't know a whole lot about
cars.
Call
your father. You call your father. No. I'm talking about on the patient. You're applying the anesthesia to me.
Well, it's a formula, you know, for everything. It's going to be different. You have to take into account their weight, their age, everything in order to make sure, like, that they're going to stay under for the amount of time needed and to make sure that everything runs smoothly.
Have you watched The Good Doctor yet? Have you watched that show? I love that show.
I watch Grey's Anatomy, Resident, everything, basically.
Now, do you talk to your dad? Do they take a lot of dramatic license there? Is it all pretty much the way it is, or do they kind of play it up a little bit?
I mean, it's basically, like, the Resident is very much like the real thing. Like, well, my dad's done so many things. He worked with heart transplants for a while and was always in the room. He wasn't the surgeon, but he would be there. He ran the machines that would help the whatever fluids it is that they would keep you alive while you're getting the transplant. So
now my favorite question to ask you guys is, you have a lot of time to think about it, but you sound like you already know what you want to do. What do you want to do when you become an adult? What do you see yourself doing?
Well, I've always wanted to go Ivy League for college. I'm hoping to go, there.
What school? Which school in particular?
I'm really hoping Yale or, like, Notre Dame. That's
okay.
Really.
Scott was a Harvard man, I believe, right? You went to Harvard? No, I was right. He went to What's the Matter You. That's where he went to school. No, I'm kidding. How about yourself, Jaxon? What's the plans for the future, my friend?
I don't look into getting to an Ivy League college. I just want to be, like, a normal person and go to
late for that, Jaxon. You're going to be
one of the normal colleges, like Indiana State University. My grandma's the president, just got elected as the president there, so she'll be there for a long time.
Indiana State, you said?
Yeah.
Okay, so he went to Indiana. He actually went to Indiana is where he went to school. But your grandmother and I and your grandparents want to vote for you for president. When can we do that? So just whenever you're ready to run?
Yeah, like you said earlier, I've been looking into being a politician. I think I would make a good one too. I don't think I'd win, but it'd be fun just to run and make the debates with all the other politicians out there.
Well, I'm leaning towards you with my vote, Jaxon. So let me know too. And I think the advertising campaign with the X boy, that we can do all kinds of things. X for Jaxon, next president of the United States. Well, a pleasure to meet you, Natalie. Pleasure to meet you. We're so glad you're going to be taking care of people like your dad is. So thank you so much for that. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
And James, thank you so much for finding time for us. We appreciate that. We appreciate that. And we know we got great people like Justin working with these people, so everything is all A-OK, right?
Thanks for having us on.
Thank you guys for stopping by today. That's our friends from the Sycamore Spartans.